As we reported earlier, federal unemployment benefits expired today for almost 9 million Americans. White House correspondent Yamiche Alcindor has a broader look at the administration's efforts to expand the nation's social safety net for those battling poverty and hunger in the midst of a pandemic.
Hi, guys.
In a year of insecurity and uncertainty,
go ahead, give her your card.
This Washington, D.C. farmers market has been an oasis for Antise Matthews.
May we get some jumbo eggs, please? This is my purpose. It's my passion to bring fresh, healthy foods to our neighbors, to our children. It just lights my world up. Would you like some juice, Amethyst?
It's an all-day trip for Antise and her daughters.
Let's go see Miss Emily.
They travel more than an hour each way on a bus and two trains to get here from their home in Capitol Heights, Maryland. Her passion is made possible because this market accepts her benefits from the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program, or SNAP, that's run by the federal government.
How important is it that you can use your SNAP benefits here? How much of a lifeline is that?
It's a huge lifeline for me because I'm able to use them and get anything from meat to eggs, dairy.
When the pandemic struck last year, Americans across the country lined up at food banks. Child hunger spiked. In December, nearly one in five families didn't have enough to eat. Congress responded, passing a bipartisan emergency assistance package that included more money for SNAP.
The extra money that I do get goes extremely far compared to what I might have been able to do before.
I'll be using the Fresh Farm dollars.
She gets an extra $400 a month. That softened the blow when she couldn't find work for parts of last year.
Come on, baby.
This summer, as vaccinations paved the way for city reopenings, Antise landed a full-time job at a grocery store. But at $15 an hour, it's still just making ends meet.
How much, baby?
$20.
Okay, I'm gonna use my little form. Although I'm working, I still need the help because rent is high. Taking care of children is expensive.
This month, the emergency aid ends, but permanent increases follow. Starting October 1st, SNAP will use a new, updated formula to determine people's benefits, one that reflects the rising cost of healthy groceries. The change means families not only avoid a cut in aid as the pandemic recedes, but in many cases will see additional monthly help to stay afloat. It's the largest single increase in SNAP's history, a part of President Joe Biden's pledge to end child hunger.
Good afternoon, folks. We cannot, will not let people go hungry.
Diane Schanzebach, an economist at Northwestern University who studies child poverty, says the update is critical and overdue.
When families have more money to spend on food, they tend to buy healthier foods. They buy a greater variety of food.
But not everyone agrees.
So I think the idea that people are going to give up on high-sugared foods, processed foods, which in themselves are not that cheap, for healthy foods, I think it's just completely unrealistic.
Angela Rashidi is a senior fellow in poverty studies at the American Enterprise Institute. She argues that an increase in SNAP should come with an increase in accountability.
Obesity and poor health that is driven by poor diet is an issue that's not unique to SNAP. But the largest federally funded food assistance program in the country should not be contributing to the problem.
Antise says trying to police how SNAP benefits are used hurts people like her who are just trying to survive.
We're stimulating the economy. You know, we're going to put that money right back into the economy where y'all say y'all want it to go.
On social media, she's gained thousands of followers and a community who, like her, use SNAP not only to buy fresh food, but to grow it at home.
So I have this eggplant here.
She showed us her backyard garden, a collection of peppers, herbs, and tomatoes, seeds purchased with her benefits.
Thyme, lavender, sage, trusting myself just to go bigger and purchase seeds on my own and to be able to do what I see, well, do what you see here.
6 weeks ago, Antise got another boost from the federal government. The first child tax credit hit her bank account, lightening her load a bit more.
What did you use the child tax credit for, and why is it important to you?
It means so much to me because I was able to purchase my daughter's school supplies and going to be able to open up doors for myself and my children.
The bill as amended is passed.
That money, $550 a month, come from the American Rescue Plan passed in March along party lines. That gave most parents monthly payments for each child, $250 a month for kids over six, and $300 a month if they're under six. President Biden has said it may be his proudest achievement.
Your head, your heart, and your budget all lead to the same place. This is the right thing to do, and it's a smart thing to do.
A new census report found that just one installment of the child tax credit on July 15th slashed hunger rates in homes with children by roughly 25%, down to the lowest figure since the start of the pandemic. It's a promising start for the program, which predictions say could cut child poverty in half.
We are showing it's possible to get big, important things done.
And it's a critical piece of President Biden's pledge to combat poverty and to put in place the largest expansion of the social safety net in more than 50 years.
It's going to mean a lot of children who grow up less likely to experience hunger, better able to pay attention in school, you know, and so that they grow up to be healthier, more academically successful, sort of better attached to the labor market in the long run.
Critics like Rashidi say programs like this that don't require work do more harm than good, especially for the most vulnerable families.
Say thank you.
The opportunity for those families is to get connected to the labor market and to earn their own living. And we need policies that support that, not undermine it.
It's a debate now playing out on Capitol Hill, as some Democrats work to pass a $3.5 trillion budget that would keep the child tax credit in place beyond December.
We should not have millions of our children living in poverty.
They want to take working families' child tax credit and turn it into a permanent welfare program.
As Congress debates the scope of post-pandemic benefits, Antise extended an invitation.
Come see and live in a community like mine and understand why these benefits are much more powerful and vital to us than, you know, the argument that people are trying to have. I have some zinnias that are...
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Yamiche Alcindor.
Also some basil that I did plant...